187 at 5810 Murata Avenue. Homicide wants you over there. The coroner thinks the broad was whacked using the army morphine. Don't say anything, Roy. Just get over there.
Well, I guess we're not busted on the street anymore. I guess some time has passed, I'm assuming. I have a feeling that last episode was a DLC episode.
What's with that getup of yours anyway? I should start introducing us as Detective Earl, and this is my science teacher, Mr. Phelps.
Your interest in my appearance is starting to get me worrying.
Like it or not, we're a dysfunctional couple now. People judge me with you on my arm same way they would a fat broad with a 5 o'clock shadow.
I really hope you're joking, Roy.
Yeah, my clothes not good enough for you, Roy? I'll show you. I'll show you. What a punk. Alright. We already have the Hawkshaw now, so I think... Sword of Justice... You know, we'll throw on the sharpshooter. It's been a while. There we go. Yeah, I guess he does look kind of like a science teacher. With a fedora. I don't know many science teachers who wear fancy hats and are packing heat, but... You know. I could just be inexperienced. Alright, so... It's a murder case, technically, but it was a morphine overdose.
I'm going
so
to memorize your name.
I guess we're going to try to figure out where that came from. Other than the now dead brother-in-law of... that gangster, whose name is slipping my mind. Newspaper? No. That's right, the parking lot's this way. Alright. Well, let's first see how far away she is. Oh, there's a little street crime around the corner. Ooh, let's do that little bit of street crime. And then we'll, continue on.
You're behind the wheel.
No, I'm behind the wheel. Not Ray. Stupid Ray. Make fun of my clothes. I'll smash his card so good, you won't even know what hit him. See? Yeah, dropped your briefcase.
We recovered the morphine. Some of it might be unaccounted for, so what? That's life. We did our job.
Closing one case opens another.
Do you have any idea what is really going on while we're wasting our time following this stuff?
Are you going to tell me?
The deal's being done right now will change the face of L.A. forever, and we're wasting our time on some hump.
Some hump? Oh, I want to go left. All right.
Someone's little girl.
Visit the morgue at the end of the month.
Any available unit, the 44 suspect.
Once again, right poor Ray was cut off. That's fine.
Unit to handle code 2 identified.
Totally. Car 11K will handle the outstanding suspect.
Roger, 11
cases. Huh. This doesn't seem too bad so far.
Detective Phelps.
Look, Phelps, in a minute a bag man named Rampley's gonna walk in here and put a mint on some horse running in the fifth. We don't care about Rampley so much as we want his boss. He's the one we're gonna put away for fixing the race.
You're hoping Rampley will lead us to him?
Bingo. Here's what you're gonna do. Get in there, blend in, wait for our mark. He'll be in a dark coat. Wait until he hands over the cash, then tail him.
Okay, dark coat. Cut, yeah. I'm so sorry. I didn't hit my mute button in time.
I'll wait outside. Keep an eye on the place.
Alright, blend in. Well, that's easy enough to do.
Seems like a decent guy.
Alright, don't mind me. Just read the newspaper. Yeah. I'm sure a guy with a dark coat isn't going to come... Oh, wait. What's this?
Give me a grand on cavalcade the fifth.
Wow, a grand. It's tailing time. I got all sorts of practice on this one. Alright, where is he? There he is. Ha! Alright, now where are you going, dude? Where are you going? My guess is he's gonna go left. Yep. Well.
Hey, come on! This ain't New York!
He would just see a hat over top here. He's like, might be getting wind.
Playing hard and seek, Mac?
Shh. Yes, I'm playing hide and seek, Mac. You're it. There. Oh.
Got it, boss. A full G. She's coming in at 20 to 1. You and I are about to retire.
LAPD! You're both under arrest!
Whoa. Oh, no! Okay, well, I'll get back to you. Okay, let's try this again. This time they're not running, they're trying to shoot me. Therefore, don't run right towards them.
A full G.
Pro tip.
She's coming in.
Pro tip from Phelps.
You and I are about to retire.
LAPD, you're both under arrest.
Ah, get behind this. Get behind it. Get behind it. There we go. Oh, my hat. Now you're dead. Gorgeous. That wasn't so hard when you don't run into the gunfire. Go figure. Well, that was easy enough.
Car 11K calling KGPL. Ambulance required at Sunset and Ivar. Shots fired and suspects are down.
Oh, are they ever down?
We're code 4, but I'll need an ambulance in a corner.
Probably two corners.
All units be advised, the 44 at Sunset and Ivar is code 4. Suspects are down.
Oh, are they ever. And you know what? We're gonna take his car. No, we won't. We won't take his car. We got 15 experience for that. Bonus. Alright. You know what? We're gonna have you drive. There.
You know the way. You can drive.
Ray. Alright. Rock and roll. Pacific Electric? Crazy. I don't know. I got nothing to say. Okay.
Second floor. Apartment 6. In the back.
Okay.
Thanks.
Dankeschön. Ich bin ein Berliner. Wow. Second floor, sixth. Sixth room in the back. Alright. Here's floor number 2, 8, 7, and what do you know? Maybe it's a place with a door wide open.
Bukowski.
Hey!
That I did. Good to see you, Phelps.
Bukowski!
You want a hug? Or can we get on with it?
Relax, Rusty. 26 years old, fashion model. Found in the tub by the cleaning lady, Mrs. Reynoldson. She called it in.
We heard Carruthers thinks...
Carruthers likes to make work for people. Overdose of sleeping pills. Falls asleep in the tub. Rest in peace. Case closed.
Hear, hear. Mal is 100% that it's murder.
Do you mind if I take a look around?
Sure. Go right ahead.
Aww. It's the old partner brigade. Just wish, No, can I just... Here, you two assholes become partners, and then me and Bukowski get to be partners. Can we switch it up? Can we switch it up? No? Okay. Damn it. Well... Oh, good. I'm glad you're hanging out there. At least she has a towel on. Should we press the I button? I think so. I think we're gonna see all the clues on this one. Woo boy, am I ever glad I did that. Alright. Well, yeah, let's start here. What do we have here? Okay.
Barbiturates.
Ooh.
What else is rattling around in this thing? We should speak to a doctor. Prescribing both drugs would make her life a roller coaster.
Huh. Benzedrine. Interesting. We should speak with her doctor.
Looks like barbiturates.
Mm-hmm. And Benzedrine. I cannot recall what Benzedrine does, actually. What else we got here?
Quality English smoking jacket. I don't know anyone under 45 who would wear one.
Ha! Haskell and Shaw. Okay. Interesting. I don't know why that jacket's a clue, except that it kind of looks like a... No, that's a woman's jacket. Huh. Maybe just to get some... I don't know. Unless it's a new one, perhaps? I don't know. Okay, looks like we have some...
Phelps? Val, we've had a look around. Rusty thinks it's a waste of time. What's your theory?
Come on, Mal. Tell us why we were dragged down here.
If the victim was alive when she entered the tub, water would have entered her lungs. The water is violently churned in the windpipe as she drowns. The result is that a lot of foam is generated. This foam is found at the mouth and nostrils in almost all cases of real drowning. Notice anything about our Vic?
May I take a look?
You might guess.
No foam. Okay, well, let's do that.
Take a closer look at her head and neck.
Alright. Just, there we go. Alright, head and neck, eh?
Her neck is bruised pretty badly.
Yeah, like she's been strangled. Yeah, it definitely looks like that. And her arms are pretty bruised. Oh?
A very unusual ring.
Mm-hmm.
Could be wrong, but it looks like a black sapphire.
Hmm. Nope. What do we have here?
Bruising on the forearms, and these look like bite marks.
Yeah, geez, do they ever.
The eyes are a classic sign of morphine, and the bruises tell their own story. I think one man held her down, and another held her arm and injected her. They put her in the bath to try to cover it as a drowning.
And spread a trail of barbiturates.
Take a look around outside on your way out and see if you can find the Surettes. It would make my theory.
The morphine would have been very quick, and there wouldn't have been much of a struggle.
Okay, so find two guys who recently bought Surettes and weren't junkies, and you might be onto something.
Hmm.
This is her in this photo? It's something else.
Doesn't give me anything to go on.
No, it certainly doesn't.
A girl like that? Maybe she was having trouble with some boys, huh? Maybe she got her heart broken. Couldn't take it anymore. So she ran herself a bath and down some hills, and then she just drifted off.
Definitely has some evidence around here. I don't know why. Can't be this, can it? No, it's just a crappy little photo. Weird.
They're there.
Maybe it's in this other room?
Okay,
Phelps. Stop spazzing for Phelps. There we go. Alright, maybe it's in this other room. No. Perplexing. You gonna show me anything else, game? Oh, come on. I already spent my intuition points. Oh, you gotta be kidding me. That's weak. Alright, well, I'll just have to do this the old-fashioned way. I know there's... definitely something else here. just an iron.
I don't think so.
No, me neither. It's just an iron. Oh, really? Are you serious? This fucking thing again? I know, it's nothing.
This doesn't pertain to this.
No, it doesn't. Because it's... And this is just a rolling pin. This is what happens when you leave the area. Goddamn ladle. You gotta be kidding me.
Circumstantial.
Yeah, because it's a ladle. Some days. Just some days, I wonder. Alright, well, I wouldn't mind talking with you in a second, but I'm not done with this just yet. Alright, what do we have here? Oh, is this her?
This is all top end of town stuff. Gives us somewhere to look.
Well, I sure don't see anything here. Not behind this picture, but maybe there's something else. Maybe a clown will jump out and scare the crap out of me.
It's been a modeling assignment.
Yeah, perhaps. Aha! Descend.
It's a place to start.
As for Miss Randall Julia. Okay. I wonder if there's anything behind this one.
Beautiful girl. Clothes certainly aren't from the Sears catalog.
Nope. Okay. Alright. Well, I'm gonna just... One last little bit there. Still gonna figure out what the heck. There has to be one other thing. Oh, it's probably in this room, now that I think about it. Oh, no. It's not. Well, this is bizarre. Maybe it was just a mistake in the programming? I don't know. I'm gonna guess that's what it is, though. Because I sure as heck don't see anything else. I'm gonna just try the bathroom one more time. Nope. Definitely nope. Alright, well, if I got something, I got something. If I didn't, I didn't. The victim is... let's see here. Julia Randall? Oh yeah, that's her. Okay. Alright, let's just take a look. Dr. Stillman is her doctor. We have the morphine. Signs of forced morphine overdose. Ugh, okay. Possible suicide. Yeah, I don't know about that. Sleeping pills. Yeah, but Benzedrine. It's amphetamines. So, don't really take that with depressants. It is a man's smoking jacket. Interesting. Black sapphire ring. Two homicide suspects suggested. I see. A modeling job. And dag nabbit if it isn't. Man, that other clue's gonna drive me nuts. But there's nothing I can do. It says it's around here-ish. And I can't see anything on the ground. And I don't think there's... I can't get up to that thing, so...
I thought so.
You thought what?
You know I'm right, Phelps. This woman was murdered, and the killers need to be found.
Alright, well, enough humming and hawing. Time to talk with the housekeeper. Good day.
I'm Detective Phelps. I'm here to try and help Julia. Do you mind answering some questions?
Virginia Reynoldson, I'm just so shocked. I feel like there's something I should be doing, someone I should call.
We can make those calls, ma'am. Who needs to be notified?
That's just it. I don't know. Miss Julie doesn't have any family in town. Someone has to set her affairs in order. Mr. Henderson, maybe? Who else is there? I don't know.
If you give the details to the other detectives, ma'am, they can try and get in contact.
Okay.
Was Miss Randall depressed about something? Upset?
No more than normal.
No, that's a lie.
Would she have killed herself for a man?
Damn it! Why didn't I select lie then?
She was a very determined young lady. One of those people who shake the tree for all it's worth.
Okay.
Did Miss Randall have many friends visit?
I'm not sure. I only come around twice a week.
Yeah, you're a horrible liar.
Why are you lying to me, Mrs. Reynoldson? Julia had men stay here.
I will not speak ill of the dead. You can't prove that.
About men staying here? How about the smoking jacket?
Who owns the smoking jacket?
I wouldn't like to tell tales, you understand. That's Mr. Henderson's.
Mm-hmm.
An older man, very distinguished looking. He seemed very much in love with her.
Where would we find him?
Oh, I'm sorry. I don't know. He said he lives in San Francisco.
What was it like working for Miss Randall?
Perfectly fine, officer.
Uh-huh.
You're hiding something, Mrs. Reynoldson. There's something about Julia's past that you don't want to tell me.
And how do you come to that conclusion, young man? What makes you think I know anything about her past?
We're gonna have to go with doubt.
I'm just doing my job. You understand that? Mrs. Reynoldson, it seems like there's something you want to tell me.
She was very high strung. Lovely one moment and screaming at you the next. She wanted it all, and she wanted it damn quick. Of course, being so beautiful, it seemed like she was going to get it. Not the way it's turned out, though, is it?
Thanks, Mrs. Reynoldson. You've been very helpful. No. One of the other detectives will take your statement, and then you can go home.
Well, guess that's that. We have a few leads now.
Stefan,
that's good.
Rusty, we'll take a look around outside and then follow up these leads. Can you get some guys to run down the jacket?
Oh, boy. Bukowski.
You think Carruthers has called it right? He rarely gets it wrong.
True.
I don't know. I'm a Galloway. I've met enough girls in my time who can't handle their dope.
Yeah, I'm sure. I'm sure you have, you scumbag.